Here at Sonnax, we'd like to welcome you to a three-part series on valve body vacuum testing. My name's Jim Dial, and I'm going to walk you through this easy and effective diagnostic technique, answering questions such as why vacuum testing is necessary, how to set up a vacuum test stand, and the best methods for vacuum testing valve bodies and other components. Right now, let's get some of the big questions answered. First, you're probably wondering what the benefits of vacuum testing are. Well, they're huge. Vacuum testing saves you time and money by confirming that the area being tested is the root cause of the transmission problem. I'm sure anyone who's been in this business for a while has run into the following situation. A customer comes to you with a specific drivability complaint, and after pulling the transmission out of the car numerous times without finding anything wrong inside of it, you've replaced the valve body. Maybe this solved the concern instantly, so you decided to keep that valve body with the mysterious problem around because you couldn't see anything wrong with it. Unfortunately, now it's gathering dust on the top shelf with a bunch of other valve bodies, which you also decided to get through later. But maybe the opposite happened and the replacement valve body didn't solve the issue. Buying a used valve body is no guarantee of better results. For one thing, it could have problems of its own. For another, the valve body might not be to blame for the problem at all, and you just spent a lot of time and money on a useless repair. Other than having a valve body test machine and all the test plates, what testing apparatus is available other than the R&R technician? Vacuum testing that valve body when it came out of the car could have identified exactly where the problem was, because with vacuum testing, you don't need to see a physical problem to find it. Vacuum testing isn't a new technique, but Sonnax was the first to develop it as a means to qualify and test transmission valves and bores for hydraulic integrity. By vacuum testing an area of the valve body related to the valve or valves responsible for a particular concern, you can quickly find a solution to the problem and make the right repair. That leads us to another big question. What does vacuum testing tell you about a valve body? We've all heard about valves wearing out in their bore. Repetitive valve movement causes this wear, which can lead to excessive clearance between the valve and the valve bore. We could refer to this clearance as an air gap. Vacuum testing gives you an inside view of the extent of the gap, allowing you to gauge the integrity of the valve and the bore that the valve rides in. Too large an air gap, excessive clearance, means that critical fluid pressure meant to be contained by the valve spool is actually leaking, which in some instances could create clutch slippage and or failure. Low converter pressure or torque converter clutch slip and the many diagnostic trouble codes related to those conditions. Looking closely at this, it's easy to see that when vacuum testing a worn bore, you could expect a low vacuum reading because there's too large an air gap, too much clearance between the valve bore and the valve. Vacuum testing a bore that's not worn will return a higher acceptable vacuum reading, since there's a smaller air gap, less clearance between the bore and valve. Getting acceptable vacuum readings in a suspect bore can be a big help when diagnosing concerns. If the bore tests fine, that might mean the problem is not related to the valve body and you need to focus your efforts somewhere else. Valve body vacuum testing is a quick and easy process that yields repeatable, accurate results. Sonnax has taken a large part of the work out of it for you by producing comprehensive and easy to use vacuum test guides. These guides are available for free in the tech resources area at sonnax.com. They show the locations of OE valve trains, critical wear areas, and vacuum test locations to help you test and install repairs in the right places. It's a great feeling to know that when a transmission is installed back into the car, it will work the first time and stay out on the road. We've given you some good background on vacuum testing here. It's a great diagnostic tool anyone can use to save time and money in the shop. In the next video, we'll demonstrate how to set up and calibrate the easy-to-use Sonnax vacuum test stand kit. And the third segment in this series will go into details on how to test. We'll vacuum test some valve bodies, explain how to and set pass-fail criteria using Sonnax vacuum test guides, and show how to vacuum test other transmission components. You can find these videos and many more free at the Tech Resources area online at sonnax.com.